Jesus said, "It is finished," and he bowed his head and gave up his spirit. So, at the end of his agonizing final journey, Jesus dies. It can sometimes seem a little gruesome, thinking in such detail about our Lord's passion, imagining the weight of the cross causing his weak and broken body to fall as he makes his way to Calvary, or the nails being driven into his hands and feet, or indeed his slow, drawn-out death as a common criminal on the cross. And then, if we bring our sins into it as well, the fact that it's through our fault that Christ suffers all these things, well, frankly, it can get a bit depressing. The resurrection's already happened, some might say. We're already saved. We should be joyful. There's no reason to get worked up about all this pain and suffering. Well, someone who said that might have something of a point. We would certainly have things completely the wrong way around if we dwelt on all the horror of our Lord's passion and death to the exclusion of the joy of the resurrection. And yet, human beings are, for the most part at least, rational creatures. We can't just be joyful on cue because someone says the resurrection is something to be happy about. We need some reason for our joy. And it is precisely in the agonizing, shameful death of our Lord that we find that reason. For here we see brought to their completion those glad tidings of great joy which the angel had announced to the shepherds of Bethlehem some 30 years previously. At Christmas, we rejoiced because God, in his great love for us, humbled himself to share in our human existence and was made man. Now, as we look at Jesus hanging dead on the cross, we see the full extent of that humiliation, the fulfillment of the purpose of the incarnation of which the angel sang. And, remembering our Lord's saying, "Greater love has no man than this, that he should die for his friends," it is now, when we see God's Word made flesh, dead for us, that we are most able to realize that God speaks to us with a word of love. Death is always a difficult thing for us to get our heads around. Any death, never mind the death of God incarnate. And in the course of history, there has at various times been the temptation to deny that Jesus can have been both true God and true man, at least at the moment of his death. And yet, anything less would make his death, painful and humiliating as it was, just another innocent death among, sadly, many such deaths in the time of his earthly life and today. What makes his death unique is that in it and through it, the Son of God revealed and applied to the human race that infinite love which we find mysteriously expressed in the Holy Trinity. And, of course, this love of God for us becomes even more amazing when we bring our sins into it, when we realize that it was because of our sinful state that Christ had to suffer. Then yes, it makes us sad. Hopefully, it makes us sorry for our sins. But it does so all the more because his willingness to die for us, precisely as sinners, makes his love all the more amazing. As St. Paul says in his letter to the Romans, "It is proof of God's own love for us that Christ died for us while we were still sinners." And yet, of course, this infinite love which causes sorrow for our sins is also the cause of our joy as Christians. It is the triumph of this love over death which we will celebrate on Easter Day. And the more we have come to know the extent of that love, the greater will be our joy at its victory. Indeed, so closely tied are the sorrow and the joy, Christ's death and his resurrection, that in the Eastern iconographic tradition, which considers the actual moment of resurrection too mysterious to depict, the icon of the resurrection shows our Lord's descent into hell. For it is precisely by his death and descent to hell that he frees us from its bonds and allows us to rise again with him. And so, as we prepare to enter these last days of Holy Week, when the Church puts before us in the sacred liturgy all the drama of Christ's passion and death, let us ask the Lord to draw us ever deeper into the mystery of his love, revealed in his death on Calvary, that we may share ever more fully the joy of the resurrection.